You can often simplify a problem by applying a Fourier transform and solving for the Fourier transform of the function instead of the original one. You can think, for example, of differential equations. A differential equation is converted into an algebraic equation after a Fourier transform. And this algebraic equation can often be solved much easier than the original differential equation. But this yields the Fourier transform of your solution and not the solution itself. So how do you find your original function back? That is what you will learn in this video about the inverse Fourier transform of a function. So what do we know? We have the Fourier transform of our function u of x, and we call it u hat of omega equals integral minus infinity infinity ux dx is the factor e to the power minus I omega x. We'll show in this video, you'll learn in this video, that the inverse Fourier transform of u hat of omega equals the original function u of x. And how do you get it? Well, quite similarly, again you integrate from minus infinity to infinity, but now with respect to omega, u hat of omega with respect to omega, and you get an e to the power plus I omega x now in the back transform instead of the minus which you had here. And we have an annoying factor of 2 pi. We have to divide by 2 pi. So that's the formula for the inverse Fourier transform. But why is this true? How do you get it? For that, we use a lemma which we found earlier, namely that the phi epsilon of x, approximation of the delta function, epsilon 2 goes to 0, this becomes a delta function. And you could also write this as an integral, 1 over square root of 2 pi, integral with respect to omega, where you put the e to the power I omega x here, and a phi of epsilon omega over there. We're going to use this lemma to prove why this Fourier inversion formula is true. So, what are we going to do? We are going to use our function u. We will take the convolution with phi epsilon of x, and then we are going to take epsilon to 0. And well, since this phi epsilon of x becomes a delta function if you take epsilon to 0, this convolution will give us our u of x. But first of all, we are going to compute it with a non-zero epsilon, with some epsilon bigger than 0. So what does this become? Well, we have a convolution, so we have our u of xi, a phi epsilon in x minus xi, and then we have to integrate with respect to xi from minus infinity to infinity. That's the definition of the convolution. Now we are going to rewrite this until we get in the form of our Fourier inversion formula. This requires some substitution step and some manipulations, but all of them are quite straightforward. Just have to do them in the correct order. So first step, get a y inside over here. So set the y equals x minus xi, change of variable. So in your phi epsilon, you get the phi epsilon of y now. The d xi becomes minus dy, but you also have to change the order of your integration variable so that cancels out the minus sign. And your u of xi, we have of course xi equals x minus y. Your u of xi becomes the u of x minus y. Now, now we can use our formula for phi epsilon of x we have over here. As an argument, we have y, so we need a phi epsilon of y, which means that we get the y over here. So we get this is, we leave this. We get a factor of 1 over square root of 2 pi comes over here. And then all of this rubbish integral with respect to omega comes over here, which is on the spot of the x, we get a y. So, like that. There we are. Now, and then we observe that we have an integral with respect to omega over here. We have a u of x minus y over here, which means that there's a constant with respect to the integral over omega, which means that we can take it inside the integral. And it gets over here. So, there we are. Now we have a huge and scary looking integral, but it becomes a bit easier. First of all, we use Fubini. We interchange order of integration, interchange integration boundaries as well. Doesn't matter, of course, you don't see that. And then we are in this step over here. Furthermore, we have an each about I omega y, and we do a similar trick. The I omega y is over here, but we add e to the power minus I omega x and then e to the power plus I omega x. So this product becomes 1. So why do we do that? Now, this part over here only depends on omega and does not depend on y. So it's a constant if you integrate with respect to y, which means that you can take it in front of the integration sign. There we go. And then it's over here. And then what's left is also nice because it only depends on x minus y, and you integrate with respect to y. So we do the trick, put new integration variable x prime equals x minus y. And then the dy becomes minus dx prime, but this minus sign is cancelled out because you also would need to invert the order of the integration variables. So do that, and you get the integral from minus infinity to infinity over dx prime. And here we get x primes over there and over there. And then we see that something nice has arisen, because what we have over here is exactly the Fourier transform of u. So here we have our u hat of omega. So what do we have? 1 over square root of 2 pi, e to the power I omega x, the u hat of omega, so that's almost what we have over there. And we still have the phi in epsilon omega. How do we get rid of that? Well, we also need to take the limit of epsilon to 0. If you take the limit of epsilon to 0, you get the convolution of u and the delta function, which gives us u. So that's what we have over there. And if you take limit epsilon to 0, the phi epsilon of omega is just the phi of 0. And that's just our normalization constant, 1 over the square root of 2 pi. So if you do that in our formula, what do we get? So we take the limit epsilon to 0 of this integral, take the limit inside, then this phi epsilon of omega just becomes 1 over square root of 2 pi. So this one becomes 1 over square root of 2 pi, take it out, together we get a 1 over 2 pi. And what's left is the integral e to the power I omega x u hat of omega d omega, which equals u of x. And that is exactly the formula for u of x. Given your u hat of omega, the Fourier inversion formula.